This particular one is one that ran in newspapers across Canada in this very year by Shell Oil Company. They claim there are all these myths that Shell's oil sands mining operations are polluting the rivers. And in their reality, I don't know what planet this is on, they say that it overlooks oil sands geology. They've been leaching naturally into the river for the past 10,000 years. And of course, that's the line that the companies and the government have taken for a long time. Yes, there are pollutants in the river, but it's all natural. Well, one thing that is really odd is that while industry is denying that anything is going into the river, they have to report their emissions to Environment Canada. It's put in what's called the NPRI, which is the National Pollutant Release Inventory. You can actually look this up on the web and see what various companies are putting out. So out of curiosity, we did that, and this is what they show for mercury. These are not our data, these are the company's data. They tripled the output of mercury into the environment between 2001 and 2008. And the same thing for lead. Lead's gone up fourfold in 6 years. And the same for arsenic. It's gone up threefold in 7 years. So how come they can report in the papers and to the public that they're not putting a thing in the river, whereas privately they're reporting to Environment Canada that they are putting out more and more, increasing very rapidly over time. And of course, we can detect this in our chemical analyses. I can tell you there's nothing wrong with our chemical analyses. We deliberately expecting this sort of boneheaded accusation from government and industry. We chose certified labs to do all of our trace metal work that I'm showing you here. The patterns here, again, the NPRI reports every toxic trace metal known to man. And you can go into that inventory, and my guess is that when you go, you'll find that most of them have increased by factors very similar to what I've shown you here.